Welcome to the meeting of the Bills Committee on Inland Revenue Amendment Tax Concessions Bill 2019. It's time and we have a quorum. Per Appendix 4 to the House Rules, House Rule 21E, we invite nominations. An effective nomination is made orally by one member and seconded by at least one other member, and it must be accepted by the member being nominated. Dr. K. Kwok, I nominate Mr. Kenneth Leung. Am I allowed to second the nomination? I second. Mr. Leung, do you accept the nomination? Yes. To the count of three. All right, we have no other nominations. Mr. Leung, please. Do we need to elect a deputy chairman? No. All right. We now invite the administration in. Good morning. Today we have Mr. Andrew Lai, Deputy Secretary from the Financial Services and Treasury Bureau. In the middle, Ms. Pak Vin Yong, Principal Assistant Secretary of the FSTB. And next to him, Mr. Chiu Kwok Kit, Deputy Commissioner of the Inland Revenue Department. And at the back, we have Ms. Chen U Chan, Senior Assessor of the RD, and Ms. Amy Chan, Senior Assistant Law Draftsman of the Department of Justice. We first invite Mr. Lai to walk us through the legislative intent. Thank you. This bill is relatively straightforward, and the purpose is to effect the tax concessions announced in the 2019-20 budget, which was announced by the Financial Secretary in February. One of the budget measures were one-off reductions of salary tax, tax under personal assessment, or PA, and profits tax. The one-off reductions have been implemented for quite a few years, although the amount somewhat differed. For the year 2019-20, in the year of assessment 2019-20, 75% of the salary tax, tax under PA, and profits tax would be reduced, and this is subject to a ceiling of $20,000 per case. And this would benefit 1.91 million taxpayers of salaries tax and tax under PA, and 145,000 taxpaying corporations and unincorporated businesses, and the revenue forgone for the government will amount to $18.9 billion. When the ILD issues the tax assessments for 2018-19, the reductions will be reflected. No tax rebate exercise would be needed, and this would achieve savings in administrative costs. We are happy to answer questions. Thank you, Mr. Lai. Dr. K. Kwok, so you have all the time. Yes, Mr. Lai, the revenue forgone amounts to $18.9 billion, which is substantial. I think our society is twisted. For the rich, you are giving them more, and for those who cannot provide for themselves, you are taking things away from them. and I want to focus on profits tax. For the first $2 million of income, the tax rate is only 8.25%, and now you are offering further reduction of $20,000. Many businesses do not mind paying taxes, but many are unable to make a profit, and they are unable to pay for the first $2 million of taxable profits. Our rents and property prices are among the top of the world, so life is very difficult for our businesses. So I would first talk about profits tax before I move on to salary tax. I don't know how the government would help the businesses who do not mind paying taxes but who are unable to make a profit. How can you help them? Mr. Lai, thank you very much. For the profits tax concession, the premises is that businesses who need to pay taxes would enjoy a maximum of $20,000 concession. For those who do not make a profit, they would not benefit. This is the correct understanding. But if you look at the FSS budget this year, the key directions are to support businesses and promote livelihood. In the coming year, we would offer a one-year business registration waiver for all businesses. Well, that amounts to $2,000. And as the U.S.-China trade tensions escalate, the challenge faced by exporters is also substantial. And under the CEDB, we have a BUD fund, and the criteria would be relaxed to help Hong Kong businesses expand globally. So all in all, we have different measures to support businesses. For businesses who are losing money, under the laws of Hong Kong, are there any restrictions to the application of losses by businesses? For example, if a business has lost money for 10 straight years after it was set up, how can the accumulated losses be utilized? Under the Inland Revenue Ordinance, the provisions are relatively relaxed for startups or new businesses who are yet to make a profit. Their annual losses can be accumulated. So by the time they start making a profit, they do not have to pay profits tax immediately. The tax burden can be offset by the accumulated losses in the previous years. So there is no time limit to the tax concessions, and there is no ceiling either.
Comparing with other countries, regarding support for startups, in the taxation perspective, we are doing quite a good job. Okay, Dr. Kwok. Mr. Lai mentioned slogans by the financial secretary, and his points are not really practical. Now, let's say there is a small business, and over the past years, they were profitable. However, the landlord increased rents by 100%. This is quite common in Hong Kong. After that, the landlord would benefit from the rate reduction or waiver, because the tenancy agreement is such that the landlord is responsible for the rates. So this small enterprise enjoys no benefits. So many SMEs do not have any benefits. For example, last year, these enterprises might have paid some profit tax. Last year, let's say an enterprise's profit was 30,000. It's not a big sum. This year, the company made a loss. So for these SMEs, is it possible that tax paid in the previous year can be refunded? So when they earned a profit of 30,000, they had paid tax. Now, Chairman, this company had not closed down. If because of loss, the company closed down, or the owner of the company just fled, then of course there's no way to help them. However, if the owner is eager to continue to run the business, then, for example, in the past few years, this company had been profitable, but this year things were difficult. The US-China trade war had a lot of bad impacts on them, and government's support did not actually benefit them. So they had made contribution to the Treasury. It's just that this year they could not continue to do so. So, for example, can you set an upper limit like 20,000? This year, they were unlucky. Did not have even 20,000 profit. So can you just give them back 20,000? Let's say you can set some conditions. They have been in operation for 3 years or 5 years, and they had paid tax before. So based on profits tax paid before, you can refund the tax paid in the previous year up to a limit of 20,000. Is this okay? I think this is fairer. Mr. Lai? I believe many accounting associations or bodies had written to the financial secretary asking whether the loss could be carried back to previous years. Dr. K.K. Kwok is saying a company may be making profit for 1, 2, 3, 4 years, but then because of US-China trade war, they incurred a loss. And so in the 5th, 6th, 7th year, they continue to incur a loss. So for these companies, how can you help them? This is the crux of the matter. All right, thank you, Chairman. We do understand that Dr. K.K. Kwok would like to help the enterprises, but on the operational level, if you consider profits tax, it is levied every year. And in the past years, all along, there has been one-off relief. So last year, the relief was set with an upper limit of 30,000. So if a company last year made a profit of 40,000, then in fact, it only had to pay profits tax of 10,000. So every year we do offer one-off relief. So for those companies that had paid profits tax, they had already benefited from the relief. Dr. Kwok is of the view that economic situation has changed, so he asked whether the government has other measures to help them. Apart from the tax ordinance mechanism or inland revenue ordinance mechanism, well, if losses are made, these losses can be accumulated in the subsequent years. If they are able to turn around in the future, then there can be offset from the profits tax. But this is not the most important point. The most important point is whether there are any other methods. In, for example, market development, R&D investment, we can see whether we can offer more support in these areas, so the companies are more resilient to downturn. So in the budget or in the government's recurring policies, there are other measures to help the companies. We do not only rely on profits tax relief to help the companies. Chairman, well, if I run a tea cafe in Wan Chai, if you ask me to develop overseas market, that is not possible. I employ 3 employees. You ask me to use or apply technology. I only use pen and papers to write. I'm already at a loss. So are you asking me to find an expert and come up with a computerization solution at an expense of 100,000? Well, this is not right. I think what you said can help the mid to large scale enterprises. I'm talking about those very small enterprises. For example, those tea cafes near Wan Chai Market and Central Market. So when rent is increased, they are not able to survive. Some old restaurants like Lan Hang Sat has to close down because they cannot afford the rent. Now you are talking about a commitment of 18 billion. So everybody should benefit. In the past, if a company had not paid even 1 cent to the government, then, well, Mr. Lai said last year it's 30,000, but then a company might not have paid anything, any tax, because it might only had a profit of 30,000. Let's say in the previous year, a company earns 38,000, and then they now only needed to pay 8,000. If a company can make a profit of 2 million, I'm sure they're happy. If an SME can have a profit of 3 million, well, if you give money to, for example, Li Ka-shing and other big conglomerates, they won't take it. But then for this kind of relief, it is given to everyone, wealthy and poor. Kwok's family, Li Ka-shing, and so on. For those who are poor, we are just saying that the government should refund the paid profits tax in the previous year up to a maximum limit of 20,000. Why can't this be done? If it makes a profit of 30,000, then nothing. You said that in the future, if there is profit, well, of course, if they have profit in the future, they will be willing to pay tax or even give you money. It's just that in the coming years, they may also encounter difficulties. If the operator next door makes a profit, the government will give them money. However, this company is at a loss. So the government is like rewarding the bright operators and punishing the bad ones. Is it the case, Mr. Lai? I think the best way to help enterprises is to make the business environment more convenient to companies and to brighten up the market prospect. I think this is a very broad issue for the whole government, especially the Commerce and Economic Development Bureau. I think all these have been done. The financial secretary understands that SMEs may face big pressure in relation to funding. So he has already announced that for guarantee for SME financing, the Mortgage Corp has lowered that to 50%, and the loan amount has been increased in order to help the SMEs. So we do want to be able to help the enterprises in an all-round approach. Chairman, this is really ridiculous. The bank will look at collateral or security when SMEs apply for loans. So they are already in difficult position. So they can only pledge their properties if there is any. However, some companies do not even have properties to pledge. The government will act as guarantor, but then the bank will have to approve the applications at the first place. So now, Chairman, banks are not charitable organizations. The government's guarantee is already based on asset evaluation by the bank, and if there is no collateral, then how can you guarantee the borrower? Well, if we have to talk about business environment, I may not be the best person in the government to explain things to you. Perhaps this matter should be dealt with by another panel of LegCo. But on the taxation level, we can also do something to help enterprises, and we are doing that as much as we can. Sorry, Chairman, we are asking you to refund tax, but not tax of the prevailing year. It's tax of the previous year. I'm not asking you to help you because I know that remote solutions cannot alleviate urgent problems. So now, if I am to move an amendment, then I will say profit tax paid in 2019 can be refunded up to a maximum limit of 20,000. Can I make this amendment? Legal advisor. Okay, Mr. Lai first, and then our legal advisor. Chairman, I understand Dr. Kwok's point. From financial management's point of view, we think this suggestion is difficult. Well, they had already paid the profits tax in the previous year, and a refund has been made already if they are eligible in the previous year. So we have to ask ourselves a question. Should we make extra refund arrangement for other special reasons? So we have to think again. Which enterprises should be eligible for this newly proposed tax refund arrangement? Now, this time in the budget, we want to share economic benefits with people and also return wealth to people. Mr. Lai, there are professional bodies which had come up with suggestions similar to Dr. Kwok's. So can the relief be carried backwards to offset profit in the past? Well, let's say this year you have a loss, and then the loss could be brought back to previous year so that there could be refund. So no longer 20,000. So the loss can be carried back for 1 year. In many jurisdictions, there is limit. You cannot use loss to offset profit made in the past 10 years. So at most 1 year. Have you considered this? Chairman, I understand your point. We have considered this suggestion. However, we have a worry. Hong Kong's tax base is narrow. Number of enterprises paying tax is rather small. In Hong Kong, there are more than 1 million companies, and only 140,000 companies pay profits tax. And 1,000 top taxpayers contribute 80% of our tax revenue. So if we arrange profits tax in such a way that loss could be used to offset, then to us, there will be a lot of uncertainty and impact on the uncertainty of revenue.
Can the legal advisor address Dr. K. Kwok's question? Thank you. Dr. Kwok asked whether any amendments can be made to the 2018 to 19 tax deductions. The purpose of this bill is to implement the budget proposal of for the one-off reductions. I believe the administration has already explained that for profits tax paid in previous years, they were already they have already been paid, and this is something we cannot change. And like the chairman said, the government can consider alternative measures, for example, setting an alternative ceiling outside of $20,000. Dr. Kwok, when you look at the long title of the bill, it is specifically about 2019 to 2020, while your recommendation would affect the tax arrangements for YA 2018 to 2019. In other words, for businesses who lost money in the previous year, simply amending the bill cannot achieve your objective. So if something is to be done, for the year of assessment 2019 to 2020, the profits tax not exceeding $20,000 already paid could be rebated. You will be touching upon the arrangements of the previous year of assessment, and this is outside of the ambit of this bill. All right, thank you. Please continue. Now I'd like to talk about salaries tax. The situation is even worse than profits tax. For profits tax, you would halve the tax rate for the first $2 million of accessible profits. So for salaries tax, why isn't the government slashing the tax rate for the first first portion by half? You are making life even harder for the poorer people. Please excuse me, I need to take a telephone interview now. All right, in that case, you would not be allowed to speak again. Can we take a 5-minute break? I believe the bill can be wrapped up by today, but I don't want to deprive Dr. Kwok of a chance to speak. All right, let's take a 5-minute break. After that, if he doesn't come back, we will proceed to the clause by clause examination.